puts me in touch with odd sensations centuries old. I'm trying to focus on this killer, but the echoes from these sensations keep interfering, like deaths from the past, pleading to be remembered.
you see all those police lines?
You hear what that guy just said? Something horrible just happened in St. Benedict's. I hear sirens.
I remember a bright flash, and then...
How long they left people underwater?
Long enough to be mighty comfortable.
My husband and I stepped off the platform and onto the giant hissing locomotive. I remember looking back at our small town and thinking of all the happy memories we made there. But I was excited to start our new life in Salem. I must have dozed off because I was startled awake by the sound of screeching metal. And as the train came to a halt, all I could hear was the torrential rain pelting against the roof. I looked out the window. There was only darkness. Then came the brightest flash of lightning I had ever seen. When my husband left to inquire about the delay, a woman in the back of the train started screaming. We rushed over to her and asked her what was wrong, but all she could manage to say through her sobs was something about seeing the spirits of the dead wandering in the rain. Stranger still were the passengers that were suddenly stricken with the painful memories of their past. It was at this point that I became truly terrified. So I set out to find Joe. When I reached the cab and still hadn't found him, I was worried. I looked out the front window and saw the train's conductor laboring to move a downed tree from the tracks. And there was Joe walking up to help. However, instead of grabbing hold of the tree, Joe bent down, picked up a rock, and crushed the conductor's skull with it. When I left the train and ran up to him, I could see that this wasn't the Joe I once knew. Something had taken hold of him, something angry. Then he saw something that terrified him. He dropped the rock and ran off into the woods. However, right before he disappeared into the trees, during a bright flash of lightning, I thought I saw something chasing him, hunting him. I can only describe it as a ghostly specter, cloaked in black. But more likely than not, it was just a shadow. The authorities spent days combing the woods for Joe, but he never turned up. I tried to go back home, but the memories were too painful. Some nights I lie in bed, tortured by the thoughts of what our life could have been if we had never stepped onto that train.
Where are you headed? Oh, no, no. Going that way. Cops and criminals get used to red and blue flashing lights. Even after you get numb to them, sometimes they still chill your bones. You can get that feeling that this time, they mean something personal. Thank God you're okay.
No, no, Joy, Joy, don't!
Damn it!
Lieutenant, caught her sneaking up the side staircase. Says she's a friend of the priest.
Where's Father McCauley? Is he all right?
Just put her in my car. I want to interview her myself. Can somebody remind Broyles that the door's not going to watch itself?
Yes, sir.
It's a simple question, please!
Take it easy on her.
Hey, anybody find Baxter yet?
Nope. Went to the station, drove by his place, nothing. You know, there's definitely something wrong here.
I mean, honestly, have you ever seen anything like this?
Half this stuff feels like a goddamn riddle.
I don't know. I just seem so demented.
Demented? I gotta find this crime scene before they cart away all the evidence.
It was somewhere around noon on a Sunday when I got a call from the pastor. He was looking for someone to fix up the old church. It had been sitting up on that hill, abandoned for over 40 years after getting hit by lightning back in 98. It suffered a bunch of fire damage. So, of course, I agreed to help. I knew something was wrong the second I stepped inside. As an inexplicable chill came over me. Anyway, I shook it off and I set to work. As I started tearing up the damaged floorboards, they were all bad. Well, I uncovered an old rat's nest. It seemed like any of the others I'd seen over my 22 years in the construction business, until I saw the scraps of human hair and bones that the rats had used to make it. Well, suddenly I heard the floorboards on the second floor creaking above me, and the sounds of a young girl weeping. Well, you know, I was worried that the damaged section of the ceiling was going to give away under her weight, so, you know, I yelled, "Hey, you know, stop, come down immediately." Well, my voice must have startled her because she went completely silent. So I got up and I went to look for her. When I entered the room upstairs, though, I was surprised to see it completely empty. It only took me, you know, a minute to make my way up there, and I would have heard her run off if she did. But that's when I heard the weeping again, only this time it was coming from the bell tower. So I climbed up the long, treacherous, curving stairs at the top, and I noticed what I thought was dried blood dotting the way. When I finally got up to the belfry, I was just paralyzed with terror. Because lying before me was the withered corpse of a young girl. Judging by her sun-bleached clothes and weathered bones, it seemed like she'd been lying there for the better part of those 40 years the place had been empty. The rats, I mean, they picked her bones clean. I took off running. I didn't stop until I got all the way to town. The ravages of time made it impossible for the authorities to get any identity on this girl. It seems Salem will never know who killed her. Some people still claim to hear her weeping there. As for myself, I never went back.
nothing sacred to this guy. The work of a real monster.
Sure, there's more clues here.
If she stayed at the hospital, she'd still be alive.
Don't hold too tight to what's keeping you here. Just remember, this wasn't your fault.
I'm sorry. What else did he do here?
Steps hold trembling feet.
still with us?
Bodies. Everywhere.
Running away. That's who he's after. Not the rest of us. We have cocktails already.
Okay, all right, everyone, let's get this picture. We've got to get to the reception now. Everybody.
Coming through. Oh my God.
Hey, it's a limp.
Let me go. Let me go. He's here.
Look, you need to back off.
These weren't normal Bell killer murders. These people were just in the way. He was after Iris. I wonder if there's more evidence in Joy's room. Trying to protect Iris. I'm sure that won't make it sting any less for Joy. Damn it.
Thank you.
don't think she's the most ideal roommate. A little rough around the edges, but I'm sure you like the room, and in time, you'll both get along really well.
Don't worry. I can get along with most anyone.
Excellent. Well, this is the room.
Here we are.
Father? What's wrong?
Go! Go!
Killer came here looking for Joy, but took out Iris instead. This is a friggin' dead end.
So where's Baxter? If he's not here, he's got some explaining to do.
Well, what about you? You see anything? Hmm?
Easy, kitty. Easy, easy. It's your old buddy Ronan.
What the hell was that? The killer dropped something in the vent. Maybe the cat can help get to it.
Thanks for the help.
I know that house. The killer's hideout. I need to get to Judgment House.
Ghost thing and get me out of this. Come on.
Trust me. You're better off this way. The killer was after you.
Oh. What happened in there?
He didn't suffer.
her lying.
He died protecting innocent people. That's all you need to know.
Died because of me.
Hey. You know, pleading insanity isn't going to help you much on two counts of trespassing and felony escape. So you can drop the crazy act, all right?
Rex, man, give her a break.
You got anything to say for yourself? No? That's what I thought. We'll figure out what to do with you at the station.
Why does this keep happening to me?
Joy, tell him what we found. They need to know it all. You gotta find a way to convince him.
Where are you going?
Killer left a clue about the ancient mansion we saw at the museum. Tell Rex about that, too. It's probably the killer's place.
Okay, I'll try.
I always heard this place was such an interesting museum back in its heyday. Now it's just a place propped up by rusty nails and rumors. A place you wouldn't dare your worst enemy to go into. All right, there it is, Judgment House. Huh. Maybe this abandoned place isn't so abandoned after all. I hate it when I'm right.